Welcome back to Xenoblade Chronicles. When we left off, Ryan and Sharla got separated on their own, and so did Shulk and Fiora. I almost said Melia. Don't know where Melia, Riki, or Dunban are. But, they're separated, so now they're just kind of wandering, getting some character bonding time between Ryan and Sharla. Cool, all very, very cool stuff. So yeah, let's do this. How come this chair keeps... Somebody keeps moving this chair way, way back. I want it up here, closer to the TV and away from all these army men that my little brother's left out.
Fallen arm, fallen arm, we're going to the fallen arm. Fallen arm, fallen arm, we're going to fallen arm.
The power pipe ruins.
It's right tide, baby! So you can see where we are compared to... Shulk is, somewhere, I don't know, but, we can't warp anywhere, so. You kind of currently don't skip to this den book. There will be no warping for us, so. Look, it's enough. Either mine, right there the eyes in the gate. I got to mine it from its position, is it again? Take on me, take me out. Whoa, look at those stars. Beautiful. Okay. I'm just gonna up here now. I don't know what's happening, but let's go this way. Whoa, okay, cutscene time. All of a sudden, cutscene time. All of a sudden, put it up for the cutscene time, but put it up for the cutscene time. Oh, that's all the alone time they get? Dang it. I was hoping they'd get more time to bond or whatever.
Wake up.
It's real fast. Oh, I can't play this before. So we're back to the classic original party set. Maybe we should change to Shulk? I don't know. We're all using anti-metron weapons, so. Lariat!
I knew you'd make your shock.
Ooh, this is like a full cutscene.
She remembers us. Yeah, she's been through a lot. I can see.
Yay, the trio of friends are reunited once again.
If only we could find Dunbar. Yeah, he'll be blubbering at the sight of us.
I don't think he'd ever cry in front of you two.
So he does cry, when no one's watching.
Yeah, he's always been like that. He's a big softie, but he hates anyone seeing it.
Oh.
Nope, I don't believe it.
I remember that speech he gave way back at the beginning of the game about how he's not gonna cry about what happened to Fiora, but I bet as soon as Shulk left, he was crying. He's probably doing one of those quiet cries though, like not where it's a sob, but like where you're kind of like reluctantly having tears come out despite the fact that you don't want to. The fact that I know this is probably really not a good sign about my mental state.
It feels more like he's the one who's been
I haven't cried in a while.
That's not true. It's okay. I know it, you know it. I'm not here to protect you anymore.
But you are here for something.
Yeah.
And that's to be right!
It don't matter how strong you get, you ain't got eyes in the back of your head. So I've got your back. Ryan, you...
Ryan, you're like a whole new person.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, it's good you've become so dependable.
What's like that?
Take it as a compliment.
Ha! You haven't changed a bit.
You haven't changed a bit! That sounds like something they would yell in battle.
Right, let's go. You want to see my brother cry, don't you?
Yeah, wouldn't miss it.
You know, whenever they're playing the thing, that awesome stuff's going on. Let's, I want to play Sphere more, so let's put it right there. We can play as Ryan later. Update. We made it, baby! Find your friends. Find the rest of your friends, okay?
Guess we'll go this way.
And then down in order to get to this little secret passageway. Oh my, there are enemies in here. Fun. Fifth pulse. Oh, these guys are normal enemies. They're not. Zero gravity! What time is? Oh yeah, baby. Flip those guns. I mean those swords. I mean those knives. I don't know. So, they needed silver antel fibers to restore Cogni 6's commerce. This is the last of the eight that Juju asked us to collect. What? Oh my god. Let's go, mate. What can I use? Zero gravity! Zero gravity! Oh wait, I just realized I don't have anybody in my party to topple moves still. It's like, Ryan's not in the party. Actually, with how easy these enemies are, I should probably put Ryan back in the party and put Sharla away. It's not what you need her, to be honest. She said she learned a new skill. Frick. Wrong! God dang it. Arts. Double blade, let's level it up. Level it up, level it up, level it up, I'm on fire! Oh, the dog. Second gear. Tense all the muscles in the body. increasing physical arts damage. Guard shift. Air fame. I like this one. Shut down. Inflicts daze on mecha as opposed to just inflicting daze in general. Oh, but it can inflict daze on a large. So the same damage as that one, so I'll see the reason too. It wasn't 200 compared to 1000, because it does a little more damage. This one inflict daze on anyone. No, it's just my bounce effect. Yeah, it's pretty much the same as the other one, so it's not bothered. Just probably easier to use on my bounce. Double blade does that much damage, that does that much damage. How much does shutdown do? Let's replace shutdown with this one, because we don't have enough. Well, too many of our characters don't have any sleep abilities, so let's get that character as a sleep ability. I'm not doing anything so much. Let's get this up. Hold this one up. Get the spear blade leveled up. Leveled up again to do more damage. Ooh, wow, 3 times the damage of topple. Dang, man. Engage! Blast on. Rage, magnum charge, burn. Aura burst. My Minato more powerful mean I can level these up all the way now? Cool. Cause yeah, the bar, their bars are full. Alright, that's nice. Shala. I have the ego for it, so I might as well, even though I don't use those abilities. This one I do use, so this one I should level up. Frick! Shouldn't have used it on those other ones. I didn't realize. Okay. Oh, right, Alan. Well, 4 parts of the game, so. We'll look at your skill trees later. Is this the way you're supposed to go, actually? Because I just came down here because I saw it easy deposit, but I guess this is the way you're supposed to go.
One of mine. I'm ready.
Whoa, let's knock them off. Hey, I was coming down. I'm coming down for you. Whoa, 2,000. And battles. I guess the guy from the guy from fire would be good. Alright, let's go. Her jump sounds sound really strange. An old man. Wasn't that like she's coughing. Makes me feel bad for her. Like it sounds like she's like struggling to function. It makes me feel bad for her. Man, it really makes me feel bad for her. I kind of repeat myself, but I don't know any other way to say it.
Come on.
Whoa. Holy crap, dude. Look at this. Look at these fingers. This is awesome, man. We're like detached from the Mechonics and the Bionics right now, because they're like standing over a vast ocean, and this is where the arm fell off. Cool. Dude, this game's world never ceases to amaze me. Probably the strongest part of this game. Definitely the strongest part of this game. But the characters and the story, are fantastic, but the world is probably one of the best that exist in a game, bar none. Walking and on, walking and on.
I can hear something. What? I can't hear anything.
Maybe
it's in
hand. No sound. More than one. Watch out. Something's here.
I hear it too. Whoa. Are those people? Mechon people? Robotic people? Vicky-pon! Hero-pon! Hero-pon! Hero-pon!
Friend, stop for Ricky. Oh, Ricky very hungry. And Ricky sleepy.
Typical Ricky. Man, I love
Ricky
this guy.
Now.
This is me in these situations. Oh, I'm tired of walking after like 5 minutes. Please let us rest.
Millia, do you need to rest?
I am fine.
Good. Break time.
Okay. Apparently, Melia is voiced by Jenna Louise Coleman, who is one of the Doctor's companions in Doctor Who. That butt shot. That came out. Okay, now we're looking at them. Now we're looking at a fish. What is happening? Oh, we going to go fishing now? But yeah, now I'm not going to be able to hear Melia the same way again. Because that's one of my favorite Doctor Who companions. So that's like awesome. I love this guy, yeah, man.
How considerate of you.
Ricky, not understand, Dun-Dun.
Don't try to hide it. You realize Melia was lagging behind. She would never admit how tired she was. That's the real reason.
Aww. Ricky Pond has secret intelligence and lots of heart!
Now that's good fish. Even in this strange place, at least the fish tastes like it should.
Ricky glad Dun Dun like yum yum fish.
Yeah, thank you.
This cutscene kind of ties back to that one part we watched between, I think it was Ricky and Dun Man, about like them fishing and stuff. Or no, actually, I think that might have been Ryan and Ricky. I don't know. What? I wasn't listening.
Ricky wants to hear Dun Dun's story, for Ricky is the hero bond.
I'm not sure what that's got to do with it. Well, seeing as you're here, I'll tell you.
Yeah, Ricky's.
I have a sister. Her name is Fiora.
Ricky, no. She wears silver armor. She'll look everywhere for her.
Indeed. Shulkin and Fiora, everyone knows they like each other. But they're just not ready, I suppose. They're the perfect match.
Well, they did kiss on the beach, so...
Even Ricky not.
I suppose I wonder. But now Fiora has become... something else.
She's still
she
kind of herself.
Shulk. She forget Dun Dun, too.
She did. But Shulk won't give up that easily. Knowing that he's out there looking for her fills me with hope. I just wish I was there with him.
Dun Dun, take
care. Is he gonna cry?
Hmm?
Sorry, I am way too excited about the idea of
Dun Dun.
I love how Ricky calls him Dun Dun. I love this. I love all of
it. Ricky, big mistake. Dun Dun, not Daddy Paul.
Well, I am your older brother.
Just like Daddy Pond.
Yeah, he's watching it. He's the father figure of pretty much the whole party, to be honest. Like, he's... Because Shulk doesn't have parents, and...
I'm getting such advice from you.
I don't know where Ryan's parents are, but, Dun-Dun basically fought a figure to all characters except for me, because I'm not a child. And Melia has parents, but, Hom-Hom, you be fought a figure for Hom-Homs. Not bird people, not Snow-Pom, but Hom-Homs. Listen to this music. Sounds like whistling. I really like that tune. So serene and peaceful. This is an awesome area. I feel happy.
It doesn't look like
that. Like, ever since we got to this area, I've just been happy. Happy, happy, happy!
Everyone's safe. Everyone's strong.
Ricky is right. It is simply a matter of when we will happen across them.
Everyone lands in the same area.
I don't know why, this area of the game just makes me feel peaceful and serene. Like, nothing, like, I'm happy. I don't know. Like, nothing could be better.
I wonder where this point leads.
This music, it's like a music box, like a lullaby.
The music is
totally distracting.
Well, I'm willing to give your
knob-on
instinct a try.
As am I.
As am I. She said that really fast. I don't think I've ever used Dunban, Melia, and Riki together, but, it's cool. Whoa, heart heart back there. I wonder if I can get it yet. Please, put a heart heart that I can actually get for once, please. Please. Where is it? I don't... I got fair piranhas.
Gale Slosh! Whoa, I just wanted to do frickin' Worldly Slash, man. Well, nice Slosh! Soaring Tempest! Spirit Breath.
We got him, man. Let's go to the snow, but I want to get the heart to heart. Where's the heart to heart? Is it over here? Oh. It's a new place for Richard. What? Oh, god dang. It is them, but it requires Riki and Melia to be buddies, and of all the people on the chart, I think... Other than Ryan, I think Melia is other than Ryan and Fiore, I think Melia is least connected to Riki. Melia's only green with Riki. She's green with Genesis. Green with envy. She's green with Dunban. Alright, let's go. We haven't met anybody here, but I know I saw some people, so... In the next episode, we will continue to explore... Arrivederci!